Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to MoreShay. Hold up, let me adjust that one time. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to MoreShay with Marshay. My name is Marshay, of course. This is my channel, MoreShay with Marshay. Today's video, finally, during these last 4 to 5 weeks, I'll say I've been bringing you all nothing but pregnancy updates and or gender reveal updates and or me talking about being pregnant update. Like, so finally today's video is not going to be about that. It is going to be about why you should save yourself for marriage. The reason I decided to do this video in the midst of being pregnant and no, I'm not married, is because I still understand and believe, and I know it may sound crazy and bizarre to so many. They may be like, well, why would you ever, you know, still have the idea in your head that saving yourself for marriage is ideal or saving yourself for marriage is a great thing? But I'm going to tell you why. Not only, let me clarify. Okay, not only do I believe in saving yourself for marriage, which is ideal if you are a Christian and you believe in that faithful background, you understand where I'm coming from with that one. But if not, I also believe that saving yourself in general, just not having sex with any and everybody, is a great golden ticket, great golden rule. And I believe that you should be very specific and or careful with who you sleep with. That's basically the whole message of this video. It's not just saving yourself for marriage, because no, I didn't. Yes, I told you in my how I lost my virginity video that my intention was to, but of course I'm human, I make mistakes. So with that, you know, I didn't do it. So how can I tell you to do it? But if it was my daughter, would I tell her to? Yes, I would express that. Even if it was my son, would I try my best to encourage them in that direction? Yes. To get as close as you can, even if you can't make it past the finish line and actually be married, wonderful. The fact that you held on to yourself until you are a mature adult, I even respect that, because for me, one thing I can say is I at least didn't have sex until I was a mature adult, meaning not just an 18-year-old where you are technically legally an adult, but past the age of 21, where you are legally able to drink, legally able to smoke, legally able to do almost everything, rent a car, etc. The legalities between 18 and 21, there is a difference. You know, at 18, there are many things that you are capable of doing on your own as an adult. At 21, it becomes a little bit more advanced. And so me, I didn't have sex before 21. And so I believe and would want the same thing for not only my kid, your kid, and every other kid, is to not only just save yourself past a certain age, to not only save yourself for a certain mark, I hate to say for marriage, and make that be the ultimate goal, because it does not have to be the ultimate goal for everybody. But when I say save yourself, I mean save yourself by trying to do the best you can to make sure that the people and or person that you decide to sleep with is someone that you actually want to either be with, spend time with, interact with, engage with. And I'm going to just give you the reasons on why I feel it's so important to be careful with who you're sleeping with, okay? That's in general. Okay, big warning sign. So the reason I feel that way, and okay, let me just give you a flashback little story. One time I was in a church and there was a pastor and he wanted me to start a group. And we were supposed to wear these t-shirts and go around and promote this for young women and young girls. I can't remember ideally what the t-shirts were supposed to say, but it has some motto, some mantra, something to do with like teen pregnancy. It was not nothing negative to demean a teen parent or anything like that, but it was a positive mantra to basically uplift yourself, believe in yourself enough, love yourself enough to where, you know, hopefully that was not a part of your journey. Now, everybody's journey is different. That has become a part of so many people's journey. That's even how I got here. So I'm not saying that, you know, being a teen mom is the worst thing ever. It happens. What I'm saying is, if you can take necessary steps to prevent certain things, it would be ideal. That's all I'm saying. It would be ideal. Take your time. So the reason I feel you should take your time, there's so many different reasons, but one of the reasons I feel you should take your time is because it's best for you. Why is it best for you? As far as your health, you don't want to expose yourself to too many different germs, bacteria, infections, etc. too early. Now, there is something I almost want to mention, but I feel like I have to save this for another day, that is personal to me and the reason I'm even saying this, this particular part here. But you want to be careful because people are not as clean as they may appear. You can look at people and think, oh, he looks handsome and nice. You can look at people and think, oh, she looks pretty and clean. But who they appear to be may not be who they really are. And so you have to be extremely careful with who and what you expose yourself to. When you begin to sleep with people, you are not only exposing yourself to who they are physically, you are exposing yourself to so many bacteria and things that they carry. And when I say that, I'm saying that to say, even if you don't catch an STD, I know you probably heard that conversation a thousand times. Oh, STD, be careful, be careful, be careful. You've probably heard the STI, the sexually transmitted infection, be careful, be careful, be careful. But not only are those things to be careful of, having sex with people could cause so many things to happen. Your pH balance can be thrown off in so many different ways. There are so many, as a woman especially, so many different things that could go on. So you want to be careful who you extend yourself to, who you have sex with, who you decide to even interact or engage with in that way. Because you want to make sure that your health is a priority. Health is very important, especially in a time like this where there is COVID-19 being rampant still, and it's 2021. You want to make sure that you are not exposing yourself to any physical illnesses, STDs, STIs. I mean, even things that are common, like, what is that thing called? Bacterial vaginosis and yeast infections and etc. Some of those things can be caused by different things. It could be what you're eating. It could be the clothing that you wear, etc. But at the same time, even having sex with people could cause some of those imbalances in your body. So you want to be sure to make sure that you're just not extending yourself to any and everyone where there is a risk and or a chance of that being even higher. You know, you want to make sure that that risk is as low as possible. That's what you want to do if you can, you know. And the thing with that is, I know it's not the easiest thing in the world. You can't always tell if a person is going to be right or wrong for you. Sometimes you could think they're doing everything right and it still be so wrong. But I feel like just take your time. I say take your time so often because even taking your time doesn't guarantee anything. You could take 5 years to have sex with a person and still it'd be the worst situation ever, and you walk out with your lips turning purple and blue. I mean, you can literally take 2 seconds and be as clean as a whistle. It's no certain time limit on how long or what will happen when and where. But I feel taking your time gives you more time to get to know the person, to find out what they are exposing themselves to, who they are exposing themselves to, so that you can find out what and who you will be exposing yourself to, okay? So just be very careful when it comes to deciding, okay, now I want to have sex with this person. Another reason, I always say this myself, is why? Ask yourself that question. I know it may sound silly. You might be like, well, because you in a mood and you feel like it. Okay, that's wonderful. But you could be in the mood and feel like it and do that by yourself, to be completely frank. You could be in the mood and feel like it and handle your own business. And as a woman, again, I can only speak for women, you might be able to do that for yourself in a much faster time. So, and not expose yourself to what you can if, or what you will if you were sleeping with someone else. Just to be completely frank again. I think that it is very important to, you know, be sure that you know the reason you're even deciding to sleep with this person or have sex with them. When you're a kid, when you're young, when you're a teenager and you decide to have sex with people, sometimes it's like, oh, I like him, so I want to have sex with him. Liking a person is not enough to have sex with them. To be completely honest, in my personal opinion, I don't think liking a person is enough to have sex with them. Even loving a person, I don't think is enough to have sex with them, because so often in life, you can love almost anybody. I had this conversation with someone and my uncle was like, what? You can't love any and everybody. You can to some degree. You know, if you be around people long enough, if you develop enough friendship or relationship or bond with the person, you can love almost anybody. Love and like is not enough to just have sex with somebody. Why? Because as much as you like them, that does not mean that they are good for you. As much as you love them, that does not mean they are clean. As much as you like them, that does not mean that they are safe. As much as you love them, that does not mean they are healthy. So there are things you need to check for. Even they may not know some of the things that they are walking around with because they didn't had it so long and haven't even been checked out. Those are things you need to know. And I think so often in life, we just hop into things without thinking fully, without even giving ourselves the chance. And there was another thing I wanted to speak about. I almost wanted to make another video about it, but I'm going to throw it in this one. I believe smoking, drinking, etc. can push you into sex faster than you might have on your regular, normal, straight mind thinking self. And so you want to be careful even with that, because drinking, me per se, when I drink, it makes me feel some type of way. I don't know how drinking affects you, but drinking affects people differently, smoking, all of it. And so when your body is relaxed, your mind begins to relax and you begin to do things that may not be who you would normally be. You know, you normally wouldn't do that, but all of a sudden you are. And so you want to be extremely careful, extremely protective of who you drink around, who you smoke around, who you feel comfortable to let your guard down around. And I'm not saying be a brick wall like me, because I've been a brick wall for many years, and I wouldn't say that's the best thing to do either. But I would tell you to be very cautious, because even being the most cautious person in the world, like I feel I am, even being as protective as I feel I am of me and my body and the things I do, I have still made mistakes. One that I may speak on in another video sometime. And even with getting pregnant, wasn't on purpose. So you have to make sure that, you know, you pay attention. As saved as I tried to be for as many years as I tried to be, I still am human. And I don't want to blame it on me being human and act like, well, just because I'm human, it's an excuse for my behavior, or it's an excuse for the things I allow. It's not an excuse. It's just what I allowed in that moment and or at that time. So I just want you all to do better than I did, do better than the next man, do better than your mother. Please don't use what my parents did it and do it as an excuse. One of the things that led me to having sex too was I was thinking in my head, well, everybody in my family did it and they're fine. And God didn't get mad at them and nothing bad happened to them. That's what I was thinking, right? But I don't know how fine they really are. So you have to be careful. Just because you think everything is okay, or it worked out for people, yeah, eventually, of course it worked out. God, you know, shaped things right. They got their lives together and they're cool. But that does not mean that it will work out the same for you. You know, the plan may be completely alternative for you. And I swear, I always say this, when I do things, things always happen to me 10 times worse than it would the next person. I could do the same thing they did. Say I took a shot of Hennessy. Okay. My whatever happens to me for taking that shot of Hennessy is always 10 times worse. And I'm not talking about specifically me drinking a shot of Hennessy, because I have a high tolerance when it comes to drinking and or even smoking. I haven't really smoked much, but I have a high tolerance for those things. But I'm saying that it's certain things that is not for everybody. And everything that everybody else is doing, say they sleeping with everybody in the world. You may sleep with two people in the world and all of a sudden you have HIV or AIDS. Like, not saying that's just what's going to happen to you. I don't want to scare you to death, but you never know. You know, things are different for everybody and circumstances are extreme for some people. And you have to be aware of who you are again. And like I said in my last video and 1,000 other videos, you are a VIP grand dame. What did Jill Scott say in the song? She said a grand dame experience. She said something like, and I spoke about it in my other video before. You know, you are a high experience that they are getting to enjoy and or participate in. Don't never forget that. I don't care what you look like. I don't care if you're not the best looking thing in the world. I don't care if you're not the best whatever thing in the world. You are a grand dame. Like, you are, I can't say that word on here, but you are it. And you have to remember that with the SH in the front. You are it. And so many people forget who they are and how they are. Like, don't forget that. Because the moment you forget, then somebody else that see you forgot will creep in and try to take advantage of you forgetting who you are. That's what people are out here doing. And I know it's sad to say. You may be like, dang, like, people just not generally good. They just not genuinely wishing the best and wanting the best for me and trying to engage with me in the best manner. No. To be honest, people are walking around with so much unhealed trauma, which is causing so many people to do any and everything. So many people are walking around, you know, thinking that it's okay because everyone else did it. that they don't know that what they're doing or what they've done is not, it's not acceptable, it's not right. And I still believe, like Prophet Karin says, holiness is right. As much as I've done myself, as imperfect as I am, I could tell you this 1,000 times over, because I feel like so many people put me in a box of being perfect, and I've never been perfect a day in my life, and I've been knew that. But even with me being non-perfect, I also still have great morals, great values, and a great mindset that I hold dear. And I feel like, you know, you should carry the same. You should carry yourself with a certain level of respect. You should carry yourself like you are a prize, like you are something to win. I don't care if you're a male. So many times people feel like it's so different for females. I'm not going to lie. I even have that mindset. I have the mindset of where, like, where a female is a little bit different from a male in that perspective. But even for males, you should be a VIP experience. In order for people to walk around saying they have a child by you, should be a VIP experience. You shouldn't want everybody walking around saying they have a child by you. That makes your value low. Not to be funny, I feel like it lowers your value, because it is just like with, what is it? I'm trying to think. It's just like with products at stores, like they say with the products that have commercials and the ones that don't. Things that are priced at a higher value are not marketed, to be honest, in a low value scene, in a low value way. You know, they don't have to promote with commercials because they are already seen as luxurious, as expensive, as worth something of high value. And so as a human being, as a woman, male, whomever you are, you should carry yourself with that same mindset and or thinking that you are a luxurious, high level, high value experience. And because of that, because of that high value, high level, luxurious experience that you are, everyone shouldn't be awarded the opportunity to afford you. Like I spoke about in another video, everybody can't afford you. And I'm not talking about a physical dollar amount. If you want to put a dollar amount on you on it, fine. I'm talking about they shouldn't be able to afford you. They shouldn't be able to experience you. They shouldn't be able to die and say, oh yeah, I did. Because why? Like, you are the it with the SH in the front. I don't know how many times I gotta remind you, you really are. So don't walk around treating yourself like you're any and everything. Like everybody could be like, oh yeah, I did that. It's like Beyonce. Let me just use Beyonce. Everybody might not idolize or love Beyonce like that, but Beyonce is Beyonce for a reason. Getting the opportunity or the chance to meet Beyonce is looked at in high regard. Why? Because everyone and anybody can't get next to her. Everybody and anyone cannot meet her. There are people with money who cannot get next to her. There are people with certain status levels that cannot get next to her. And so you have to remember that it doesn't matter who this person thinks they are, remember who you are, you know, and remember how great and grand you are. Like I said from the beginning, number one, make sure that you're careful with who you sleep with, how you sleep with them, and why you sleep with them, just because of safety, of health. You want to make sure that safety is first. Health is a number one concern, okay? Safety is first. Number two, another reason that you're making sure you're protective of who you're sleeping with, maybe even saving yourself for marriage, is because you are a prize. Like I was just saying, you are a prize. You are a high value, luxurious item that cannot be purchased for a low price. You are a prize. Number three, it was something else I was saying in between those two. I'm trying to refresh my memory of why you should. And I think it has something to do with, making sure that you're ready for that. Making sure that person is ready for that, that you know the why, that you know the reason that you're even deciding to sleep with people. Because, I mean, for what? Be sure to ask yourself. I don't care if you're 16. I don't care if you're 17. I don't care if you're 29. I don't care if you're 45. Ask yourself why. And if you still decide to do it, then fine. But ask yourself why. You might think again. You might be like, yeah, why am I doing that? Like, what for? So ask yourself, okay, just to be sure that you know why you're doing it. Just to be sure that you know that you come at a high cost, a high price. They got to be able to afford it. And just to be able to know that your safety, your health is a priority. Okay, those are three big reasons already. And I'm just going to keep talking briefly. Again, make sure that you understand the value of you. Don't sleep with any and everybody. The reason I would say marriage is because having a Christian background, I feel as though God did design marriage for a reason, and or the sanctity. How do you spell that word? How do you say that word? But like, you just want to be able to save something for something. That's how I feel about it. You want to be able to save something for something. If it's not marriage, maybe for you being engaged, or for you, not even if it's not even about a marriage or a ring, maybe it's about you being in a committed relationship. Maybe you want to wait until you are in a committed relationship. That's even a goal. That's a great one to have, because not everybody does that. People go around and they do what they want to do, how they want to do it. And again, you have no choice but to respect them if they're being healthy and aware of the choices and the decisions they make. But again, I just feel, my personal opinion, who am I to tell you? I want you to save yourself, do the best you can to take your time, because men, women, and or people are out here doing any and everything with any and everybody, and not everybody cares and loves themselves enough to choose better. I want you to care about yourself. I want you to love yourself enough to choose better. I want you to care about yourself to the point where you feel like I'm so solid in who I am that I shouldn't and I couldn't be out here just doing any and everything. Because again, a grand dame experience, that's what you are. And because you know that, you carry yourself as such. Don't go out here just giving any and everybody you, so they could walk around and be like, oh yeah, I did, and oh yeah, I had. No, you didn't. You can't afford to. So stop lying. Like, I love when people say lies that are hilarious and delusional, because it's like, you know that's untrue. And when you hold yourself to that standard, more people want you, to be completely honest. They want you, not to be funny, but I'm wanted. And I know they want you. They're going to want you. And I'm looking very light. My color is dull right now, but they want you. They want you even more because they feel like, oh my God, not any and everybody can have her. Not any and everybody can have access to him. So now I want that type of access. We always want that exclusive access to something. We always do. It makes us feel better. It makes us feel good. So when you know that any and everybody can't do something, but you can, that's something different. That's something special. So be careful with who you have children with. I done said that 1,000 times over. I know, who am I to say that? Marshay made a mistake too. She's imperfect too. She's gonna be completely honest with you. She ain't gonna lie. But I want you to be careful. I don't want you to do what I did. I want you to be careful with who you have sex with, which I do for the most part. I want you to be careful with who you have children by, which I try to. I just want you to be careful. To be very careful. This is a big warning sign, this whole entire video. Not saying don't do it, never worry. Have your fun, enjoy your life. You know, it is an experience that only, you know, you'll get to do once. But make sure you do it well. Hold yourself to a standard. You might be like, this one boy, like when he was trying to ask for my number, I was like, try again, like another day or whatever. He went to my school probably. I don't know, but I've seen this boy somewhere before. And he was like, well, what if I die tomorrow? Like, I ain't gonna lie, I was kind of childish at the time, so I thought that was a good line. Like, what if I die tomorrow? Oh, you might as well give it to him today, because you never know what happens tomorrow. That boy ain't dying tomorrow. He'll be perfectly fine. I'm gonna just let you know. So if anybody try to throw that line out there to you, they try to throw anything stupid out there to you, like, what if I die tomorrow? What if I'm not here tomorrow? Oh, I can't wait for tomorrow. Tomorrow may not come. Welp, then I guess I'll meet you in heaven. I mean, that's when you will see me. That's when it'll happen. Other than that, you're good. Because 9 times out of 10, that they ain't going to die tomorrow, to be completely honest. Now, if they do, oh my gosh. But 9 times out of 10, they are not going to die tomorrow. So save yourself. Save other people. Save, you know, your future children by just making sure you are being intelligent and wise with the decisions that you make. Because every time you sleep with somebody, there's an option of getting an STD. There's an option of getting pregnant. There's an option of getting some type of infection. There is an option of getting something you can't get rid of for life. There is an option of hurting yourself, maybe mentally, emotionally, spiritually, physically, financially, all of that. Because some people, they become a burden to you. So you want to make sure that you take your time and choose wisely. And if you could save yourself for marriage, engagement, or whatever your goal is, do so. This is Marshay with Marshay, and I just had to give you that brief little synopsis on why I feel you should save yourself. I'll talk to you guys soon.